Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind. I'm Amethyst Sluntari. Slurring my words, what the hell's going on? Vending slash ice. So we're here on the VIP guest floor. Finally got access to it. Guess we'll come back to that, especially since there's a security guard here.
Why'd Helen have to go and die in our hotel?
Oh.
We don't need that kind of notoriety.
Well, this isn't locked. They like to destroy these places.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
She's got enough alcohol around? Or remnants thereof? Close this up. I want to steal things.
Like wrapped among the rocks.
Oh, okay, whatever you say. Jeez. I guess the shower has become a drinking room. Yeah, I'm gonna look at it, don't worry. The Dissonant Queen, Chapter 2, continued. Two huge shapes suddenly bore down upon them. Halcyon Helen saw that these were the same creatures she had faced on Maximilian Mercer's ship. From the waist down, they had human attributes, but above were slick and jet black. These were the Dissonant's evil agents, half-men, half-giant, limbless slugs. Helen, acting with canid-like swiftness, darted out of the way as the first slug struck out with its fangs. Olympus Opal, however, was not as fortunate. So paralyzed was she by the first creature's visage that she could not defend herself from the second. Its teeth clamped down on her neck, and after a few moments' struggle, she expired. Having regained her footing, Helen drew the Spacer's Choice pistols taken from Mercer's corpse, still functioning well despite their economic make, and let loose. And ere the first spent casings met the ground, both slugmen lay in pools of their own blue blood. "Apologies, my friend," Helen said sadly as she looked on Olympus Opal's still body, "but I wish you had heeded my warning. The colony has lost a great employee today." And with that, she shouldered her pistols and stepped into the Marauder base. Okay, then. She did that. Oh, a signed toss ball stick. I don't even know if I stole that or if that was a take. But there's a picture of Halcyon Helen. Oh! Is this where he stayed? Champion toss ball blocker.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Yeah. Champion toss ball sticks. That moved around. You make me think of someone coming towards us. We've been found out. The signed one. Brady Holcomb believes his signature tossball stick must actually bear his signature. It's scratched into the handle and smeared with old bloodstains. Wow. Alright, there's nothing else to do in here other than see what's going on. Halcyon Helen's footprints?
A single footprint. Size 10. Tossball cleat sized.
Oh, not hers. Okay, amplifier. Analyze the footprint for any residue.
The soil in this residue contains a very high concentration of oxygen.
High concentration of oxygen usually points to a terraformer.
Well done, Inspector. The weather monitoring station at the pilot house substitutes for a terraformer. The soil in his footprint likely came from there.
This isn't enough of a lead. Better keep looking around. Well, there's another clue.
The charred fragments of a letter lies at the bottom of this waste basket.
Amplifier, can you identify what was on the letter?
Unfortunately, most of the writing is beyond recovery. The words station, meeting point, and emergency are all that can be discerned.
Station.
Well, glad we narrowed that down.
Poke in the ashes. It's cold. Any idea when this happened?
Someone burned this letter shortly after Halcyon Helen's death.
Alright, all the clues I've found point me to the Phaeton Pilot House's weather monitoring station. Anything else? No, okay. We got that locked one. Yeah, these rooms I've been in. Sealed. Oh, that's the elevator. Never mind. These are locked. Ah, that's where I'm supposed to be going. Let's go there last. Burbage 3001, you're the other suspect.
Initiating banter protocol. Now simulating familiar and welcoming demeanor. Burbage 3001 is trained to recognize all board-approved actors. Greetings, fellow star. Your performance in Maverick Johnston's latest drama was memorable.
I see you've had some work done. Who upgraded you?
Burbage 3001's programming is frequently upgraded to adhere to board-certified standards. The most recent upgrade was performed by Spencer. Woolrich. Banter protocol exhausted. Reverting to default behavior. Grieving and despair. Oh, Halcyon Helen. May your atoms be commended to the Aether.
You knew Halcyon Helen? Well, he acted with her in the serials.
Burbage 3001 was designed to disrupt Halcyon Helen's monopoly over the Aetherwave serial market.
Oh.
This unit's programming is based on Helen's most famous roles. Burbage 3001. Anything Halcyon Helen can do, this unit can do slightly worse.
I thought this auto-mechanical acted with her. Never mind. It almost sounds like you've got a motive for murdering Helen.
Now running shock and dismay protocol. What's this? Helen's death was a murder? How horrifying.
Yeah,
bring that killer to justice, designated authority figure. This unit has not yet completed its grief cycles, randomizing despair tables. Oh, Helen, is there no justice in the world?
Yeah. That's a pickup, not a steal. What's that say? Oh, it's all in binary. I wonder what it actually says. What's this? What is this thing? Pneumatic piston. These are takes. Huh. They look like makeshift crowns. The Oxonian. I got Oxonians. Weird.
This unit has not yet.
Yeah, this unit. Well, that's blood, looks like. Oxonian. Jesus. Is that blood? All right. I wish that's our destination. I want to see if we can get in these locked rooms, because he's gonna... I don't think we can open those. But he's walking my way, so... not the best time to try to get in here. Come on in. I gotta close it again. Interrupted. Metallicis gel. I want that stuff without going out of sneak. Alright, let's go out of sneak.
Nice and easy.
It's a general idea. Classic Wear Express. Never mind then. Another gelicure. Fashionable, upscale, and contemporary. Custom made and available in less than a week. And then we got all these Oxonians. Simple, classic, time-honored, the top hat, the most venerable of all headwear, now available from Jolicoeur, if I'm saying that right.
Nice work.
Classic wear Umbra. The latest and monochromatic elegance. Impress your friends. Allow 2 to 4 weeks for delivery. Wow. This is available in less than a week. I guess it takes longer to make those. Alright. Well, no blood or black crap spread around here, at least. I want to try these doors. I don't think I can open them, though. Nope. Not even close. I can't even boost it enough to get in. I wonder if you can find a different way in. Alright, let's talk to Spencer Woolrich.
Thank you.
timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Oh. You got some kind of trophy here. That's nice. Huh. You are talented, you are magnificent, you are a joy for others to be around. You're definitely not a two-bit hack. You bring life to the world around you through the art of theater. With great fortune to you, Spencer Woolrich. Why does he have a picture of himself? Wishing him... I guess he just hands these out to fans? We're just looking around his place. Haven't even talked to him yet. Oh, look at that.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
These pictures. He looks exactly the same in each one. There's more of these signed autographs. Chief of the Savages. That's who you played? Chief of the Savages? Well, it seems to be clueless as to our presence, so let's check the terminal. Welcome, Spencer Woolrich. Reminder, you have a fingernail in goldening appointment at 5:30 tonight. Alright, from Spencer Woolrich to management. Well, now it says the two, and the other ones wasn't saying. Subject, new room urgently demanded. Oh yeah, he's the one who keeps asking for a new room over and over again. There seems to have been some kind of mistake. When I first arrived at the Grand Colonial for this unveiling, I was led to a small sitting room, the kind that an individual might be allowed to relax in with moderate comfort before being led to his actual quarters. It has been a week and a half, and no one has arrived to deliver me to my actual room yet. If I didn't know better, I might assume that this was meant to be my actual room. If I didn't know better, I might assume that you tried to play Spencer Woolrich, star of hundreds of serials, the hero of Aetherwave sets colony-wide, in a room where he can hardly walk from one end to the other without bumping his toe on the foot of his bed or his shoulder upon his desk. Aw, too small for you? I might even assume that Ruth Bellamy was placed in the Grand Cathedral penthouse suite on purpose rather than by mistake, but I'm sure the issue will be rectified soon, and our positions will be swapped. I hope you won't try to tell me anything to the contrary. S. Woolrich. Okay, from management to S. Woolrich. Subject, renew room urgently demanded. Mr. Woolrich. While the Grand Colonial staff understand your consternation as being placed on the VIP guest level of the Grand Colonial, we're afraid that there was no mistake. Ruth Bellamy, as current spokeswoman for the Spectrum Brown unveiling, is currently slated to have the penthouse suite. An actress of her station deserves only the best. The VIP guest floor comes in very close as the second best section of the hotel. The penthouse suite is only about twice as large as your current lodgings, and the amenities it provides are only perhaps three or four times better than those you have access to now. Your current lodgings are proper for an actor of your caliber. I'd say it's three times as big, because we got that other room, remember? This is like the bedroom area, and then there's that big area when you walk in, and then when you walk in to the left, there's another area with a big table. So I'd say at least three times as big. From management to all guests, subject, guest safety. Oh, wait. If you have any other requests, we'll be sure to respond to them after we get to Ms. Bellamy's, the Grand Colonial Management. Okay, guest safety. We're sure you've no doubt heard of the horrible event that occurred in the Grand Colonial Ballroom earlier today. While we know that many of you are concerned for your safety, take heed. We've heard your concerns and know that nothing quite says safety like dozens of guns. Armed security will be present all throughout the Grand Colonial on every floor except employee floors, 24/7. Freely go about the hotel premises and spend to your heart's content without worrying about someone shooting you in the back of the head. Management. Okay, let's talk to him. Halcyon Knights. Look at it. Odeon Pictures presents It Came From Edgewater. Remember Edgewater? Full of thrills, chills, and terror. Starring Spencer Woolrich as the monster. Hail, monster.
About time you arrived.
What?
You haven't dressed the way I asked you to, but I suppose that was expecting too much of a non-industry lout.
I don't think you
expect a complaint to management. Now, unless you'd like to waste more of my time, I suggest we begin rehearsing.
I'm not...
Ready?
Yo, I'm not...
You've fallen right into my trap, Captain. Oh, don't bother to fight back. You cannot hope to stop me from installing philosophism as the system's reigning ideology.
You'll never take over Halcyon, you fiend.
How does the scenery taste? Good, I trust. Wait a moment. You're not wearing a bellhop's ID. Which must mean you're not Owen's understudy.
Fast study? Not really.
Can't even be relied upon to find his own replacement. Oh, no, this is curious indeed. Who are you? And how did you get in here?
I'm here to investigate the murder of Halcyon Helen. I'd like to ask a few questions.
You're here to investigate me? Oh, I assure you, I'm nothing special. Just an old crook with more money than time.
You're a crook?
That was a quote from The Retiree's Revenge, in which I played an ex-thief turned decrepit old man. But, of course, I'm certain you already recognized it.
Not at all.
Now, what shall I sign first? Your weapon? Your wallet? Or perhaps something... A little more personal? Undergarment signatures have been popular of late, or so I've heard.
Make a rude gesture. How about you sign this?
I'd be delighted. Oh, damn. My pen's out of ink. I'll just get you a portrait of my face as a souvenir. I'm sure I have the prints around here somewhere.
They're everywhere.
By the by, how did you get in here? The only non-staff individual cleared to enter guest rooms is supposed to be the inspector for Bellamy's murder. Oh.
Wow.
Oh! Hello.
Fold our arms. Hello.
Hi. Terribly sorry, Inspector. I didn't realize it was you.
No kidding.
I understand that I am beyond willing to comply with your search for the fiend that did Bellamy in.
Maybe I found him.
No, now that I look at you, you're the perfect reflection of me.
Oh, please,
back
no.
Back when I starred in The Marauder's Bane, the absolute picture of justice. Ask me anything at all. I might even give you a straight answer.
You better give me a straight answer. I hear you were poisoned?
Indeed. The agonizing bowel pain was most undignifying. While I've certainly had no shortage of inadequate hotel meals, this was most explicitly pronounced. I suspect poison. And who would be most likely to poison me but Chef Anwar?
Oh.
We've clashed almost non-stop about his slop preparation. He must have tainted my meal in retaliation.
Why didn't you go to the clinic for your stomach pains?
Is that a jibe?
No.
Could you imagine the tabloid headlines? Spencer Woolrich, Aetherwave star, spotted in gastronomic distress. Oh, unseemly hardly describes the half of it.
According to the coroner, Helen was also poisoned.
How alarming! Whoever targeted her was certainly targeting me. I can only thank my ironclad constitution that I'm standing here before you.
Helen wasn't killed by the poison.
Oh. Oh! That's very good to know. Perhaps the poisoner simply meant to incapacitate us both, disrupt the product launch. I couldn't say, Inspector. I'm merely an actor.
Can you think of anyone other than the chef who'd want to harm you?
None that I can think of. I treat all hotel staff equally, and with the minimum level of respect that they deserve.
Yeah, I believe it. Alright, that's all I wanted to know.
Very well, then.
Who are you exactly? I just want to offend him.
I'm sure you're joking. Perhaps I'm not in my prime, but you've no doubt seen the name Spencer Woolrich on many a serial advertisement throughout your travels.
Never heard of you.
That can't be. You must just not remember.
Nope.
Or perhaps you only recognize my characters, not my name. Did you ever see me in The Masked Marketeer?
Nope.
The Busker of Byzantium?
Can't say
what
I have.
About episodes 13 and 190 of Princess of Hephaestus?
Not at all.
And who could forget from Halcyon with Love?
I could.
I was great in that movie. Even if I was starring beside a 2-ton bucket of bolts and a woman with no talent.
Busker of Byzantium? Helen wrote a bee to implicate her killer before she died.
I think that's a bit of a stretch, don't you?
Nah.
If you're going to come after me, I expect evidence. Unless you want to be smacked with litigation. Smacked!
Do I have some more questions to ask about the poisoning?
Go! Oh, must I relive that ghastly event again? My intestines still have yet to fully recover. But I suppose we may discuss it further.
No.
Very well, then.
I'd like to ask you about the murder.
Certainly. But one quick question before we begin, if I may.
No, after.
How was it that Bellamy met her end?
Why are you so curious?
Why, I'm merely worried for my own sake. Perhaps whoever came after her could come after me next. But if you don't want to tell me, I understand. Whatever happened, I hope poor Bellamy didn't suffer.
No, her own last name is starts with a B as well. Did you know Helen well?
Bellamy has been my co-star throughout the autumn of my career. I should like to think I knew her. In fact, I cannot name a single role in the last 10 years that did not involve her in some way. Unless you count the uncredited silent shopkeep on Melissa's Meteoroids.
Why did you keep starring alongside her?
I'm not too proud to admit it. I couldn't get work on my own. Hmm. Whether or not I wanted to accept it, Bellamy had captured the eye of the colony. People kept talking about the charisma we had on screen, but I felt more chemistry with certain teacup canids than with her. As you may have been able to conclude, I wasn't terribly enamored with Bellamy, but that doesn't mean I'd kill her.
What were you up to at the time of the murder?
I was meditating, of course. That's how I get into character.
Got anybody who can corroborate that?
Respectfully, Inspector. It is rather counterproductive to commune with others while meditating.
So you were meditating, really?
All actors have their methods. And this has been mine ever since I met that wonderful prophet of profitability. She taught me it for my role in The Unemployed Cometh. I had to lie face down on artificially heated pavement. The director wanted our suffering to be convincing. Needless to say, being able to leave my body helped to mitigate the pain, both during the 8-hour shoot and with the second-degree burns afterwards. I owe that woman much.
Right. How long have you worked with the Prophet?
Yeah, actually, only since I've been at the Colonial. The Unemployed Cometh was shot on site. That makes it a few weeks. I cannot recommend her services enough. If you haven't been to see her yet, you really should.
Yeah, I really do have to pay her a visit. All right, back to my other questions.
I'll answer whatever you wish.
So, speaking theoretically, how would you have killed the victim?
Oh, come now, Inspector. What do you take me for?
A murderer.
I'm an old man. I neither have the time nor the willpower to kill people for fun.
For fun.
Besides, I have my reputation to think of.
All right, so maybe it wasn't for fun. Maybe you kill people for other reasons. All right, well, back to my other questions, then.
I suppose that is enough on that grim subject.
I've learned a thing or two about your activities in the hotel.
Oh? Have you now? Please do go on. Don't leave me in suspense.
I spoke to Burbage. He told me you upgraded him.
I did indeed. With Halcyon Helen parading her fame about, I was left without an acting partner. Burbage is no exception. His acting protocols were nothing short of a joke. So, I decided to make some modifications, installing him with some of my old serial quotes, as I think improved his range. The way he bungled about with that weapon of his hardly befitted a dissident. So I modified it as well. He's much quicker on the draw now, though he's still a machine.
Right, whatever. I also found a bottle of tainted liqueur. Might have had something to do with your poisoning.
That, yes. Yes. I distinctly recall ordering an alcoholic beverage with my meal. This hotel is certainly bringing a new meaning to the phrase rotgut. Management shall receive the complaint to end all complaints.
Well, I got my eye on you.
I'm quite used to being breathlessly watched.
I'm gonna breathe while I have my eye on you. Well, I don't really need that stuff. I imagine he wouldn't like me taking it. Wait.
Beep, beep, beep. Time for discrepancy detected nearby.
Forgot. What's this?
Discrepancy detected. This bottle, recently discarded, contains residue from foreign substances.
Oh,
chemical
that?
Analysis complete. This unit has detected the following substances. Oil, terroray. Blood, terroray. Unidentifiable biological fluids, terroray.
So my question to him, or my comment to him that I found this alcohol bottle, this is it. So I actually had not yet found it. Were these substances added later?
Yes, Inspector. Logical analysis indicates these substances were not present in the bottle's original contents.
Is it toxic?
These substances cause extreme gastrointestinal distress in humans. Large doses can be fatal. This bottle contained Rizzo's Spectrum Vodka. The presence of terroray biological fluids may have significantly improved its flavor.
Still want to ask Nyoka about it, but I don't have that option anymore. So, I think there's nothing else we can ask.
You're here. I hope you have the photon proto-distributor.
The what?
Or we're never leaving this damn facility. That was from the Twin Spies. I played a sentient mechanical. Ask me anything at all. I might even give you a straight answer.
No. What's that noise I'm hearing? All right. So we need to speak with Chef Anwar. We need to go to the meeting spot to meet the mascot. We need to talk to the Prophet of Profitability. We need to investigate botanical operations, and we still need to add the chemical to the pool filter. And we need to meet someone on the balcony. Alright. Maybe it's the balcony here in the hotel. That would make sense. Well, that'll be next episode. You guys enjoying the episodes? Thanks for watching. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.